This is the Distance Learning Anarchy series on podcasting. This episode is setting up a WordPress blog for podcasting. This is Michael Dean from the Freedom Feens radio show. It's also a podcast. It started as a podcast. You can do podcasting very well, easily. You can also do it very wrong, easily. With a little bit of help, you can do it right. There's a lot of ways to do it. I'm going to show you how I do it. My show started out as a podcast. It's now on radio on 25 stations. But it came from podcasting, and, you know, someday we'll probably all end up back on just podcasting. But we do podcast every day. I put a lot of work into it, do it manually, edit it. I'm going to do another video on actually doing the audio part of it. This part is on setting up the WordPress blog and optimizing it to be really simple and really easy to navigate for the user. A lot of people have podcasts. A lot of people do like spoken stuff with video on YouTube and call it a podcast, but it's not really a podcast because it doesn't have an RSS feed and MP3 files properly tagged, easily available. And I'm not saying, oh, it doesn't obey my rules. I'm saying it doesn't have the wonders of what a podcast is, which is a completely portable radio show that's syndicated by RSS feed. You can download it. You can get it easily. You can take it with you. You can consume it while driving or flying a plane or anything. You can't do that with video. All right, so the first thing I do is go to the Freedom Feen site, and you're going to look around it. It's a lot of stuff on it, but everything is really simple, and the podcast feeds are over there right in the right-hand corner, the iTunes feed and the podcast feed. So go down the page to the bottom right, near the bottom right, and get click on the link, the HostGator affiliate link. I like HostGator. I use them. I wouldn't recommend them if I didn't use them. All right, so what I would recommend is go to the web hosting part and get the business plan. It's they have specials from time to time. Depends how much it is, about 100 and something a year. If you get 3 years at once, if you get a domain name and pay 3 years at once, you have slightly higher SEO or findability on the search engines. But you don't have to. Go ahead and type in your domain name you want. Get your domain name, or if you have it somewhere else, you can. If it's already hosted somewhere else, you can just point it here. That's out of the purview of this, but there are lots of stuff online on how to do that. So fill everything out, then click on yes, submit. I agree. I submit to your demands. You don't have to book 3 years at once like I'm doing here. All right. So then you're going to get an email that's going to have a login. You're going to go log in to their panel. And then you go down, scroll down more, keep scrolling. Okay, you're going to go down to software and services and click on quick install. And then you're going to go, you're not going to have all this stuff because you haven't installed everything yet. You're going to go to WordPress over on the left. That's the software you want. Click on WordPress. Click the continue button. And I'm putting it in a subfolder. You're probably not going to want to type anything here because you're probably going to want to have it in the main folder of your domain. But I already have a podcast there. But so you fill out the rest of this. Put in your email. I forgot to put in my full email. But put in your name of your podcast, your username, your first name, your last name. You put whatever you want there. I use my real name. Hit install. And, of course, it says you didn't put your full email. So I have to go back up and put my full email. All right. Then this little status bar will look like it's sticking and not going to go anywhere. And then it will suddenly spurt up to 100%. Whoop! There we go. 9900. All right, congratulations. And you're going to have a password here. You'll also get an email about this with the email you set up with. So go to the site and enter your username and the password that you copied. I would click Remember Me, log in, and update password so your browser saves it. All of this is done in Firefox. Most of this will work in other browsers, but I'm doing it in Firefox. Other browsers may be a little different. Okay, WordPress, you'll probably have to update it. Go ahead and do that. Update now. And if you give something like this, just go ahead and click please try again. All right, so you have the latest version of WordPress, and it will update automatically. All right, so you go to plugins, installed plugins. Get rid of Hello Dolly. That's useless. Yes, delete it. Get rid of this little connect to WordPress thing if you want. I don't need to do that. I don't need to connect to WordPress. I don't social network. You don't want to add lots of superfluous plugins. Lots of plugins can conflict and or make your site run slowly. All right, so you're going to deactivate Mojo Marketplace and then highlight it, and Jetpack by WordPress to delete them. Go to bulk actions, delete, apply. You can Jetpack has some stats, but you can add it back later if you want. I don't use it. Yes, delete these files and data. Dun dun dun. Okay. Waiting. All right. So do not, under any circumstances, remove WP Supercache. It makes your site run better, and it'll keep you from getting kicked off your host if your site becomes popular. It's not the bandwidth that matters so much with these shared plans. It's CPU usage from WordPress, and WP Supercache will cut down on that and speed up the serving of your pages. I put a link below configuring it, but I'm going to walk you through it. Go to settings. All right. Go to the easy caching on if it's not on. Hit update. Even if it's on, hit update anyway. I usually do that with everything. Go to advanced tab. It's the only other tab. Cache hits to website for quick access will already be highlighted. Click use mod rewrite. Click compress pages so they're served more quickly. Click 304 not modified browser caching. Click don't cache pages for known users. Cache rebuild will already probably be ticked if it's not ticket. And mobile use will probably be ticked. If it's not, go ahead and tick it. Update status, and go down to, let's see, mod rewrite rules. Click update mod rewrite rules, and then it'll all turn green. And then go down to garbage collection, change it to 3,600 seconds. And scroll down, change expiration, hit that. All right, then go all the way down to rejected user agents and hit save UA strings, even though it's already there. And you're done. You're all ready to protect yourself against the central scrutinizers and bot attacks and a whole bunch of crap in your site will host faster. You're going to get this warning, but you can ignore it. 304 browser caching is only supported when not using mod rewrite. I'm told by HostGator that that's fine. Don't worry about it. All right, so if you don't have PodPress installed, search it and find it. See, it's right there, but it's already installed, so you don't have to install it. And I go back and forth from tabs like this a lot. It's a very useful way to do things. All right, so read the PodPress thing. It's activated, or activated if it's not. Akismet, you'll have to go over to the sign up on Akismet key thing, that link there in the description up at the top, and you'll have to sign up for an Akismet key if you don't have one. That keeps you from getting spam. It's very useful. Without that, you'll pull out your hair. All right, updated Akismet. Anything that's not updated, update automatically. Now, we're going to settings, general. All right, tagline. Just, you know, make up something there. Better than what most people listen to. And then check. You don't need to make people register to comment. Search your city right here, the nearest big city in your time zone. Leave that set that way. Date format, time format set that way. Week should start on Monday. Don't do anything for press this or post via email. If you want to add a category, go to post categories in another tab. Make up the name of your category. Give it a slug line. Then hit add new category. Then you go back to the other tab. And refresh it. And you'll have another category in the drop-down menu under default post category that you can pick. Radio. All right. That took me a long time to figure out the first time I got on WordPress. All right, leave that all the same. I'm going to post some services to paste in here that get you, when you ping, when you do a new post, I'm going to put them in the notes, a link to them. You will be found on Google and elsewhere a lot quicker after putting up a new post, like instantly. All right, then save that, then go to reading, settings, reading. Didn't change anything. Don't ever hit that. Okay, but hit save changes anyway, even though you didn't change anything. And then go to settings, discussion, click that, click that, click that, unclick that. I'm vaping. I like to change that to newer. I like the newer comments at the top of each page. That's a choice you can make. Click that, click that. Scroll down. Leave that. Helps get rid of spam, even after a kismet. Avatars, I like to change. Yeah, R, that's fine with me. Save changes. Okay, settings, media. I didn't change anything here, but I hit save changes anyway. Permalinks, we're going to change things on permalinks. Settings, permalinks. Change it from the post name to default. The post name, some people say it helps your SEO, but it really doesn't. And it makes, they've changed that, and it makes your post title URLs so long that sometimes they'll break in an email or something. So save that. Yep. All right, I really hate the theme that comes with WordPress right now, and it doesn't do well. It doesn't show RSS feeds. It's clunky. All right, so add new. There's a couple I like. You can use any you like. You can change them whenever you want. I like 2010 and Pilcro. They're both really simple and work really well with podcasts. I'd recommend you start with one of those if you're not experienced with WordPress podcasting, which you're probably not because you're watching this video. All right, so add the theme. And activate it, then hit refresh. There you go. That's the theme. And you can change the color, the cover image. It's got your tagline there. All right. All right, that's Pilcro. And then if you want to change the, if you want to customize it, go to customize, go to header image. You can add new image. You can upload something. Select file from your desktop or any folder. I made this thing. It's just a reverse of the Freedom Feens thing. It's all my co-hosts, but it's a negative of it just to have something to insert and show you. All right, you can crop it. Should auto crop. Hello world. Okay, save and publish. There you go. Hit refresh. There it is. And close that. All right. Next, go to posts and get rid of that stupid hello world post. Trash.
Trash.
And then do the same with pages. Trash.
Trash.
All right. And do a lot of looking at the front page and refreshing it after you make changes. Get in the habit of that. All right. Add an about page. You know, you can add something and add something, change it later. I'm cool and my podcast is the best podcast in the world. Here's more information. And there should be a spell check built in there. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. All right, move it down, put in a picture. I like to put pictures on every post and every page. People don't like just seeing a lot of text. They're more likely to read the text if there's a picture there. I put a picture of a cat. I put pictures of cats on everything. Cats power the internet, man. Without cats, including my cats, the internet would fail. Whenever the internet's slow, I just upload some more cat pictures. It speeds it up. Yep. All right. Never put your email address anywhere on the web unless you want to get tons and tons of spam every day. I recommend instead using the contact tab plugin. Go to add new, search contact tab. And there might be a few things with this name, so make sure it's the one by Sam Hagen. Install it. Yes, install. Activate. And then go to the settings. It's going to be over here on the side. Settings, contact tab. Click on it. Put in your email address. If it doesn't automatically, put in your email subject. I put in from the Feens who love the Feens or something like that. And then save changes. And then it's going to look like this. It's kind of classy, kind of out of the way, kind of easy to find. Cuts down on spam and has that kapachapa or pakachapa, ketchpapachapa, whatever it's called. All right, worms. Okay, now you want to get rid of some of that stuff on the sidebar. Go to Appearance and Widgets. The ones on the right are active. The ones on the left are inactive. So drag the ones over you don't need. Refresh, they're gone. You might want to put the recent comments or posts back in once you have a bunch of posts and comments. All right, now go to PodPress, Feed iTunes Settings. Put your summary in there. This stuff's really important. This is basically putting up your transmission antenna to the world. All right. Let's see. You need a 14 by 1400 image for your logo. So I'm going to open up the Photoshops. There you go. Do my imitation of you suck at Photoshop. You suck at podcasting. All right. 1400 by 1400. Give it a background color of some sort. There we go. Black. That'll do. Grab another image. Cats are always good. You want to make an image that is going to look good and have detail big, but also be recognizable as something as small as like 144 by 144. So you got the cat there. Make it smaller. Drag the kitty down. There you go. That's fuzzy. Yep. My wife's out of town. That's my wife's cat. It's our cat, but that's the one that really likes her, and it's been going nuts. It's been hunting its brother all over the house. Meow. Fuzzy's sleeping next to me. I'm surprised he's not yelling. He usually makes appearances on radio and podcasts and tutorials I do. All right, put in another image. You know, you want stuff that's related to the podcast. Like, okay, let's pretend this is, you know, a negative of the Freedom Feens, and we got all this stuff with all these different hosts in here. Yep, nope. There it is. I found it. Move it up. Move it up. Cover that other one up. All right. Now I got to put some words at the top. I like to use drop shadows. I do them really old school 1996 Photoshop 1.0 style. All right. Let's show you how to do this. Yep. There you go. I know this is easier in the new in this new version of Photoshop, but I kind of still like doing it the old school way. It doesn't take that long. Yep, my cool podcast. Make it bigger. There you go. I debated making this more centered, but then I wouldn't be able to show all the menus. And I could have made the whole thing smaller and shown all of it, but I like it bigger because it's easier to see everything. I really hate a lot of tutorial videos that are, here, make another layer. All right. Yep. Nope. Another layer. I hate tutorial videos that sound bad, and I hate ones that the music's horrible and sounds too loud. I'm going to try not to do that with this one. And I hate ones where you can't really see what's going on, even full screen. There we go. Okay. Move it over. Yep, yep. All right. Move it around. You suck at Photoshop. You really do. But, you know, that's really shocking colors. Do we want to keep those colors? I think not. Let's see. Let's see what we do here. You know. Mm-hmm. There you go. That's kind of rude colors, but less rude. Looks okay to me. I like 1996 web colors, though. All right. Here we go. Move around a little bit. I don't use grids or anything. I just kind of eyeball it. It works out okay. Close enough for jazz, man. Close enough for rock and roll. Close enough for punk rock. All right. Now save the Photoshop file with layers without flattening it. Layered. Large. All right. Now you're going to export it. I'm going to export as a TIFF. Save as a layered TIFF, I think. Yep. TIFF. And flatten those layers. Squish. And then save for web. Big at 1400. All right. Yep. Give it a name. Makes sense. You got to be careful with the size. Here's something I found out from trial and error. When you go to submit to iTunes, if everything's perfect and it still doesn't accept it, your image was too big of a file size. It says it can be up to like a meg or something, but it really can only be up to like 300K. So you really have to find the right settings there. All right, so launch your WSFTP program, or if you're one of the cool kids, which I'm not, launch FileZilla. You're going to use your FTP program to make a new folder on your web server. Call it Audio. Go into the folder. It's going to be your main folder. It's not going to be a subfolder like this with me, but with mine. But you're going to make a new. You're going to make a new folder called Audio and a new folder called Assets. I'm assuming you've already made your file. That's actually going to be another video that you've already made your first episode. I'm going to show you in this how to make an MP3 of it, but how to make a great MP3 of it. But it's going to be another video on how to actually record and do a show. All right, My Cool Podcast. You should make a folder. This is where all your stuff's going to go, and try to keep it in sensible folders and subfolders inside of it to keep it organized. It'll make it easier if you ever have to replicate it. If the site ever gets taken down or, you know, damaged or anything, you have to redo it, and just it makes it easier to back it all up. So everything that's on the server side should probably have a folder with that name with same subfolders on your side. All right, so you take that big image and you upload it, and then you got to get the file path of it. And I never guess these. I always actually do them stuff. Yeah, I always have folders called stuff. I always actually like find them like this on the web. Assets. All right, so copy image location, and then go back into your PodPress settings and paste it in over that stupid Mickey Mouse thing that they have. That click on it and it should update. All right, there you go. Yep, that's a smaller preview of it. Author, put your email address. You can also put your name next to it. I just put the email address. Put some key tunes, keywords for iTunes. Anarchy, government sucks. Statists are dumb. These are the ones that I would use. ANCAP for anarcho-capitalist. LibPair for libertarian paradise. Libertarian paradise. Libertarian. I invented the word LibPair. Libertarian podcast. Anarcho-capitalist. I have to spell it out and copy, spell check it. All right, now put in the hyphen there. You know, don't put more than about 20 words, something like that. All right, pick some categories that make sense. Don't lie. Pick the best, closest you can. All right, education, because I'm educating y'all with everything I do, news and politics, and, you know, occasionally a funny guy. So oh, I think we should put humor in here, too. Where is it? Comedy. Okay, explicit. No is yes is if it's filthy, you know, if it's a sex podcast. Clean is if it's radio friendly. No is if you occasionally cuss. I put no for this. On my radio one, I put clean because it is clean. But iTunes block, no. Leave the feed ID blank. You're going to put that in later when you get an ID after you submit to iTunes. Okay. I don't know why I did that. Okay, read all that. All right, now you need a smaller image, 144 by 144. So, back to the Photoshop. Jog down to the Photoshop. There, take that TIFF. I would make it a 350 by 351 first, because you're going to need that for encoding the images. Then save for web as a JPEG or PNG. There we go, 350. Then copy that and make a 144 by 144 one for the pod tunes. All right, save for web. Here we go. Okay, drag those into your assets folder on your desktop, and then you're going to want to drag them. You want to upload them with your FTP program. You can't upload anything bigger than like 7 megs directly through WordPress, and most podcasts are bigger than that, so I do everything with the FTP program. All right, hit refresh. There it is, 144. Copy the image location. Copy link location. Paste it in there. Click on it. Should show up. Yay. All right, English. Politics. I change copyright to Creative Commons attribution. If you want your stuff heard by the world and you're on a mission like I am, use Creative Commons attribution license. You don't want to put copyrights and stuff because then people have to ask you to reuse it. All right, PodPress feeds. If that's not clicked, feed podcast, activate feed, click it. Don't click premium feed. Do not. Okay. Scroll down. Add the same categories. Wait. Oh, I had to check them. All right. Here we go. Your email address in there again. Make sure it's right. Okay, get that big image again. Copy the location. Scroll down. Paste it in the iTunes preview. And then get the small one. Go down and paste it in the iTunes language, English, if you're English, if you're American English, or English, or Australian English. All right. The feed you're going to put in later after you get accepted to iTunes. Add the link to the blog header. Yes, for sure. Check everything. Looks good. All right. Scroll down to the bottom and checking. Then hit save down at the bottom. That blue thing that's below the fold. All right. Now go to PodPress general settings. Leave that. Scroll down. All right. Change it from end to start. Otherwise, people can't find your pod player. Player enabled button. Yep. Show. All right. Download enabled. Show download text, enabled, yep, update. All right, then you're going to go to PodPress player settings. All right, first thing you do here is change it from 70 to 100. It makes it really loud, and if you have a good clean file, it makes it really loud. That's a Freedom Feens trick, although I also normalize my audio so it's louder and clearer. All right, so you can, there's not much to do here. You can change the colors if you want. I usually change just the left and right because that's what you can see when it's closed. You use the color picker. Don't pick something too dark or you won't see a little speaker icon in it. And it won't show up with colors on all browsers. It will on Firefox. I don't think it does on Chrome. Chrome's stupid. You're probably using Chrome. Most people do. Firefox is better, except when it updates regularly and you have to change all your settings back. All right. Yeah, I changed two things here. The color. Excuse me. All right. Yep. So, save settings. Okay, go to your widgets. You want to drag over the PodPress feed buttons widget. You want to check those two. You want to check that. Scroll down, hit save. Now refresh. Now over there on the right, you can see the podcast feeds. Should be there, both of them. That's good. All right, now open up Lame Drop, which I will link. I changed the settings to 96. That's a good target rate. Standard 96 sounds good, but the file sizes aren't too huge. I've experimented a lot. It's a perfect combination. All right, auto tagging. You can put some stuff in here. You have to edit a file probably, but I put the year in. Don't forget to change it when the year changes. Put the artist in. Album. All right, accept. Now, here's the files that you want to change in the program. Sometimes it saves them, sometimes it doesn't. But if you click on this file, this text file, you can add like genre and album in there. And artist, if they're not in there already. Sometimes it'll save it, sometimes it won't. I haven't found a better MP3 encoder, and we're going to tag them separately anyway later. There you go. All right. So you drag your, you got your episode. Make a folder for it, 2014 audio. Another one that says, 2014 waves and MP3s. Okay, in the MP3 one, you're going to want to make separate folders. You can also do this in the wave one if you want. Wave ones are good to save, man. They take up a lot of space, but, you know, if you ever have to edit something or you want to put something in a movie or you want to use something later, it's better to have the uncompressed audio of it. All right, and I put month folders in here too. And I do that on the other end too. So drag it in the wave, then drop it. That's a really short file. Okay, exit, lame drop. So there's your MP3. Drag it to desktop. Go to the MP3 folder, 08. Drag it into your month folder. And then open up Tag Scanner. And drag the MP3 in. And see, you got some of the tags here. So all you got to do is, you want to do artist, album, year, genre, composer, grouping, and put in your picture, and that's it. Everything else is superfluous. Oh, also track number. I didn't put it in here. It should do it automatically because it's in the file name, but you should put in track number here. I would put 000. Well, there's no O's, and just put in one, but I put in O's in the file names, and I put a file name that's descriptive and has no spaces. And I put in like 00001. So, you know, they alphabetize correctly when you have 1,000 of them. All right. So you take your 350 pixel picture, drag it in. Drag it into Tag Scanner. If you do all this and it doesn't take, you can see in the bottom right there, the status bar, it takes a few seconds. If it doesn't take, you have to re-click on the file in there and do it again. If you click out of it, it'll stop taking it. All right. Okay, check it all. It's all in there. The picture's in there. The name's in there. You can see the picture in the bottom left before I moved it over. All right. Okay, open WSFTP. You can set the initial remote folder, public HTML, you know, initial local folder. You can set if you want, so you don't have to dig down into it every time. All right, so I didn't set the remote folder correctly. It's for my other podcast, how it's set. All right, so there you go. That's your audio folder that you created on that side. Make another one for the year. Make another one for the month. All right, now we're going to drag this file in here. And there it goes. Okay, all right. All right, here. Go to the audio folder. Dig down in. Find it. Right click. Copy link location. All right, so get rid of that post. I didn't show you me doing that post, so you're wondering why it's there, but I did it. All right. This is going to be your first podcast. Here we go. Dun, dun, dun. All right. You have a name saved somewhere. I save them in its text file, email, whatever, because I have to put them in more than one place. I always put the name of the podcast in the title because then when you share it on Twitter or wherever, it's not just the title of the episode, it's the title of the podcast. So otherwise people aren't going to know what that is. And it helps with socially networking and sharing. All right, put a picture in there. You can just drag it in and drop it if you want. There you go. Boop. It's done. Then you hit OK. Type some stuff. Howdy. Howdy, everyone. I'm going to save the world from tyranny. Here's my first post. Should be first episode. I think we'll change it. Hope you dig it. Okay, now let's say if there was a lot more text than this. Here's a trick I like to do. If you have something really long, I usually put in a more tag, which doesn't put the whole thing on the front page. Yeah, you just go up here and click on the more tag. There you go. More. Yep, that's very helpful. I hate posts that are really long and don't have the more tag. Because you have to scroll, 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 scroll. All right. Now, add media file right there in location. Then you want to get the title without the podcast name because iTunes will put it in and everything else will put it in. Put the title there. File size. Auto detect can take a while with longer files. Duration. All right. Put in a couple tags. Tyranny. Liberty. Cats, podcasting for fun and no profit. All right, hit the add button. All right, looks all looks good. Hit publish. Do 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 do. All right, go to your front page. Hit refresh. There it is. And let's play it. There, it's playing.
Wake up and smell the cool freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help.
Continue reading. That's where the more tag works. You get all that on another page. Okay, check your RSS feeds. That's the pod one. All looks good, and it's got the file there in the bottom. Go back, check the iTunes one. It should open up iTunes and download it. And if it's correct, you'll see the image, and you'll be able to play it.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do.
If it does this, where it doesn't have the image, it doesn't have a playable file, it looks like it's trying to get it, but it didn't fully get it, that's because you made some changes in the... okay, go ahead and delete that, because you're going to want to re-download it. Delete. All right. You have to take the PodPress feed thing out, the widget out, and then put it back in, and then put the settings back in it. You have to do that every time you make updates in the PodPress settings. It's kind of weird, but go ahead and put the information back in. Hit save. All right, hit that. Hit save. And close it. And if you go to the site, if you refreshed it, there you go. It's downloading, and you've got the image. It's a very frustrating problem with PodPress, but there's that easy workaround. Okay, so you've got Akismet. You want to add one more plugin. You want to add the Twitter plugin from Best Websoft. Best Websoft. There you go. That's the one. There's a few called Twitter. That's the one you want. Install it. I don't bother with Facebook plugins. Facebook's horrible. And you don't really need a plugin to do it. Most people will just click something in and it automatically adds the title, but Twitter doesn't. So you need this. Go into the Twitter settings, Twitter plugin settings. All looks good. Scroll down. Save it. Scroll down. All right. Now there's going to be a... There's, you click Twitter plugin, it'll post to Twitter with the link. You also have shorter URLs, the way I had you set it up, so you can put more information in Twitter if you want without running out of characters.
Wake up and smell the freedom.
It's all good.
One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help.
Should also give credit to the Freedom Fiends. I got help from the Freedom Fiends, and I'll show you how to put in a link here if you don't know. You should too. All right, so go to Freedom Fiends site. I always copy links. I always copy URLs so I don't make mistakes typing them. All right, so there we go. Highlight what you want the link to be the link, and then go up to the little link button, paste it in there. It's a link now, but you have to save it. Yep, should be a capital T. I did that funny. All right, I'm gonna delete this test podcast when I'm done, so don't try hacking it. I know I left in the passwords, but there's gonna be nothing to hack. Nothing to hack. Okay, go to my friend Nick's podcast, Anarcho-Yakitalism. It's an-yak.com to look at what pages he has. This, you don't need a lot of pages, but you need these pages. I would put an about page that has contact on it, picture, donate, PayPal, and Bitcoin. I also usually put that it's not tax deductible, but I'm square. Pick my battles with laws. Don't want them to be able to take my stuff away too easily. All right, I helped Nick set up this site. It's a really good site. I like it. It's a good podcast, too. Okay, legal. I would go and basically copy and paste his legal page. It's about the Creative Commons. Make sure you change the name of his podcast to your podcast. But host the image, please, on your site. Drag it to the desktop and then upload it. He copied this from my podcast, and it's easier to find on his. Mine's kind of becoming the Winchester Mystery House of the internet. So much stuff on it. And yaks. You know, he does talk about yaks, so he has a picture of his yaks on there. Him with his yak. Home, about, donate, legal, and then one other page. All right, so the Stitcher and TuneIn, you're going to want to submit to them. I'm going to show you briefly, quickly, how to do that. Let's see. Okay, you should export at this point. Save it. Back it up. Tools, export. Yeah, when you're done doing, I do this after every post too, or after do a lot of changes, and there. So it's going to update, it's going to put this little text file somewhere, wherever your downloads go to, and I would make a backup folder for it, put it in there. Do that every time you update, every time you do something. So go to submit to iTunes, iTunes Store, how to submit to a podcast in iTunes. It's pretty easy. You just got to jump through all their hoops, look through all this stuff, and then do it. And like I said, if it doesn't work, the 14 by 1400 image you're using is too big of a file size. Make it like 200K. All right, Stitcher. Search submitting to Stitcher. And even if you spell it wrong, you'll get corrected. Go to the content providers page. There's all the information you need there. It takes about a week to get approved to all these places. And they don't always send you an email. They say they will, but I would set up a Google alert for your podcast name in quotes. Okay, submit to TuneIn. Really, these are the only three you need to submit to. TuneIn, Stitcher, and iTunes. All right, broadcast help, TuneIn help center. How do I add my podcast? Basically, you send them an email, and it just has to have this information in it, and a 1200 by 1200 pixel image, which is you have to make special. because the one we had before was 1400 by 1400. And there's your XML, you know, your feed. You have to copy your feed, right click on the feed, not the pod, not the iTunes link, but the just the feed link. All right, and the logo. So to make the logo, open up your Photoshops, go down to the Photoshop, take your big flat, and your assets, your big flat TIFF, all right, 1400 by 1400. Okay, copy it, paste it, and then reduce the size to 1200 by 1200. Make sure it's constrained proportions. Okay. Save for web. I try to put descriptive file names on everything. Makes it easier to find later when I need it. All right. So you want to email that to them. Put that in your assets folder. When you're on Stitcher, when you're finally on, take your URL for Stitcher, paste it into a text document, go to Freedom Feen site, eventually. All right. Drag that image to the desktop. Don't hotlink it from my site, but take those two images, put them in your assets folder. Then you're going to want to upload them to the assets folder on your site with your WSFTP program. Okay, copy the link, the image location. Go to your dashboard. Go to Appearance, Widgets. And you're going to drag a text widget in. It's down there somewhere. All right, put it up there. You're going to have to do some HTML here, and I'm showing what it is. I did a close-up to make the image show on your sidebar and make it clickable as a link. There you go. If you don't know how to do HTML, there's a lot of tutorials on the interwebs. That's done, except we need to insert. Well, yeah, I put a paragraph there, but we didn't put in the link yet. Okay, grab it from your Stitcher. There we go. All right, so put it right in there in those quotes. That is a working hyperlink with an image. Scroll down, hit save. You don't need to do it for iTunes because there's already an automatic iTunes link in there, but you want to do it later. You want to do it for Stitcher and for TuneIn. That's the end of my tutorial. Hope it was helpful. And go to freedomfeens.com. There's some links below where I'm posting this video. And there's also, if you want to donate Bitcoin or PayPal, that's helpful too. Send it around. I want more Liberty people doing media, and tell two friends, and thank you for your service. Worms.